Alright, take a look at our journal. Got a few more areas that were discovered, I guess. The Hunt. Further north, check Hamilton Lodge. So here, let's take a look at the map. Oops. Alright, I'm right there. And the Hamilton Lodge is over here. Way the fuck over there. Alright, never mind about that. And plus, I still have to get past the ice wall. So I gotta figure out how to get past that. There were those four, like, figures standing in front of it. Yeah, in the early access, I couldn't get past the doctor's house. Like, there was, like, an invisible wall going that way. So now that the game is finished, let's go to old Razer's place. It'll be a completely new area. But I've already checked everything here. I've got all the information, I think. So, let's go. Oh, yeah, adjust the graphic settings a bit.
Great care had to be taken searching this place full of oddities. Everything was important. The decor itself told a story.
Adjusted the graphic settings. I got rid of that grain film effect. Should look a little bit better. I don't like that effect. I usually turn it off, but I missed it. So let's go to old Razer's. Hopefully no invisible wall. Oh. Something happened here. Note of that. I really like the driving mechanics. It works really well. It's like almost like a little bit more realistic than GTA 5 first person controls for driving. Feels like that. Imagine this if this game was for the Vive. It was VR, that'd be pretty cool. Razer's house. Completely new area. I have no idea what to expect, so this will be fun. First things first, I'm gonna try to build a fire. I have a log in the back, so hopefully I won't need that. It's locked. Oh, oh shit! Holy shit!
Whoa, my banana.
Who the fuck is that? What's up? Can I come in? Or are you gonna shoot me? You cool? You cool?
Je m'attendais pas à ce qu'un étrange retentisse par ici. Moi te dire, je prends plus de chance depuis que ça rôde dans ce bout-là. J'ai ma carabine au bout du doigt, et puis bang, 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 si ça s'approche.
Bang, bang, bang. This guy is so French. Just look around his house now, just rob him. Let's talk to this guy.
Si tu veux du linge.
If you need warm clothes, city boy.
Je dirais pas non à une bonne bouteille de
carabine. I wouldn't say no to a bottle of cherry. Oh no, it's not cherry. I think he said whiskey. Shit, I missed that part. So he needs some booze. Then he'll give me some warm clothes so I don't have to freeze to death.
Oye, 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 y a un petit gars d'écarté dans ma maison.
Just staring at him. Take a look at whatever he has.
Voici le livre là. C'est le Wendigo. Ouais.
Wendigo.
Un guerrier qui devient un loup pour se venger de sa grosse peine. Et...
Huh. Tales and Legend, page 1. It's the legend of Wendigo. Dates back to a time before what anyone but the tallest trees can remember. Spinelessness, balance broke forever. The dead were piling up on an ancestral lands. I don't want to look around his house. He'll shoot me with his shotgun. He's got it pointed right at me. Oh, it's not a shotgun. It's like a carbine. Alright, we'll look for some booze for that guy. I'll keep an eye out for that. Locked. There's nothing over here. Nice view though. A gallon of caribou. Alright. Yeah, he doesn't want beer. He wants caribou. So, and he's gonna shoot me if I look through his shit. Oh, there's a key. Look at him opening my shed. Take it. I don't care. Waste your time looking in my trash as long as you bring some caribou. Key to his shack. I really didn't expect there to be other people around here. That's cool. Him showing up like that. Cigarettes. Can I smoke? Probably. Let's try. Consumables, cigarettes.
Carl, like many of his contemporaries, felt like he had more trouble breathing when he wasn't smoking. Yeah. Cigarette was his own personal breathing assistant.
Empty gas can. I already have one of those. There's nothing in here. Except for the empty gas can. Alright. Off to that one dude's house. Jeez, I'm driving like a drunk person. Wait, let's go take a look at that. Chest. Maybe there's some booze in there. Some photos. Oops. Painkillers. Some clothes. There's nothing else around here, I don't think. I think I'd go crazy too if I heard this song over and over again. Ooh. I need to find a place to warm up. Where am I on the map? Alright, I'm pretty close to that next building, so let's go. Right here. You know it's a new area when there's loading screens at the beginning. House of the Patriot. More people in here, should I watch out for? Take a photo of that. Throw it away, yeah, right. It's not letting me keep it, whatever. Cigarettes.
The place looked more like a pigsty than a house. A heavy stench of curdled milk, cheap alcohol, and boiled cauliflower filled the air.
Quebec
Back
Liberty.
Then, in Africa and elsewhere, people were ready to take up arms to stand against the yoke of English imperialism. In Montreal, mailboxes were blown up, abductions were carried out, and violent manifestos were distributed to media outlets. But around here, in the great northernmost, all a man could do is curse out loud against the faraway evil and pray for the revolution to arise. That man, by any reckoning, was from that very stock.
Quebec liberation will happen by force or not at all. We will prevail. Huh. What is that? Looks like a sponge.
It est Jean Blouin. Seems like that pig had a name after all. Rock music invaded the minds of men even in the remotest of places. The man didn't own a turntable, though, so there's that going for him.
Why wash dishes when clean ones are within reach? A gun rack? A gun rack. You got me a gun rack? It's from Wayne's World.
You had to be out of your mind to cook up white whiskey at home. The all-surrounding stench of alcohol alone was probably enough to gas a man to death.
So you got a bottle and then question mark. You could try that later. Drawers are overrated.
The rag reeked of fermented vomit. Carl wondered how one could bear to live in such gross and horrid conditions. Carl knew right away that the owner of this place wasn't a copper collector. No, this was a junkman's base of operations. The guy definitely seemed like quite the expert in scavenging scrap metal, with or without permission, surely. In the right hands, red metal could sell like hotcakes. Carl now knew how to quench the drunkard's thirst.
Oh, there we go. All right. White whiskey, too much, isn't valid quantifier for that. Cherry wine for added mellowness. Spices to taste, just a bit, tiny bit. This is in stew. So I need white whiskey, sherry wine, and spices. I have the sherry wine. Spices, I may have to go and look for that. Same with the white whiskey. Long Island iced tea. This guy liked to drink. Alright.
You had to be out of your mind to cook up white whiskey at home.
And there's another hatchet back there. Can I jump over this? Go around. Not sure what this is. Oh, it's a archery range.
With a homemade shooting range such as this, it wasn't hard to imagine a stray bullet ending its course inside the flesh of an unsuspecting passerby. Granted, Carl thought, there wasn't much in the way of passersby around here.
Bullseye. already have a hatchet. I don't think there's weapon degradation in this game, like Zelda.
That truck had obviously seen its share of gravel roads. Carl wasn't a mechanic, but he could easily tell that only the most heartfelt prayer would bring this old beater back from its slumber. With that cold, however, it was more likely that it would wait until next spring to wake up.
Warm up. All right, let's go. Go to that other guy's place. Lamuth or LaRuth? What? Yeah, just down the road.
If Carl had at any point wished to get his hands on some caribou, he couldn't have wished for better than a distillery like this one.
Need the ingredients. I mean, I probably could get some of the stuff at the general store, but I'll go look there after this. Let's take a look at this. Oh, it's just wood. Grab a couple more pieces of wood, just for safekeepings. I like how it can see the stuff that you have in the back. Can't remember this guy's name. All these French names. I mean the place I'm going to. I can't remember his. It's like, wait, let me take a look. No, never mind. It's like Ruth or something. Padlock. Maybe I have a key. Bienvenue. Oh, I have a pincer. Alright. I'm gonna drive in here so I don't have to run so far with my vehicle. In case there's wolves. Or Wendigo. Oh, I can't drive in there. Okay, never mind. Lamuth, it's not Ruth. You have any white whiskey?
Well, this truck's not going anywhere. Where were the amputated parts? Carl grinned as he pictured a Frankenstein-esque car lying around somewhere made of parts from a dozen different vehicles.
Whoa!
Another worrisome victim of this ice. This one seemingly petrified in action. The poor man, before being frozen solid, seemed to have been defending the entrance to his cabin. But from what?
Alright, we found one of the figures. So we have one out of four. It's dark in here. What is he doing? What's that? Oh. Is that like a UFO? Somebody threw fire in here, or a lantern. Is it aliens?
Something very important must have been in there for the man to take such time and effort to hide it. But Carl didn't know how to reach it.
Nice. Looks like he was building a spaceship. I could totally rebuild it. Screw it, let's do that. Astronaut.
It was an indisputable fact that machines like this entailed a level of intellectual finesse that Carl was lacking.
Homemade flying saucer, like life never crashes, or life never ceases to amaze me. Huh. I'm expecting
the week of October 5th, thought Carl. That was this week. The plug should have been here by now.
I'm expecting a nice spark plug around the week of October 5th. It's already paid for.
The very first steps of man on the moon were made more than a year ago. The event had surely captivated the mechanic's mind. For him to still keep this around.
Something isn't right when you... Your bed is in your garage.
To all appearances, Carl concluded, the owner of the place had moved more essentials from his house inside the garage. Peculiar man indeed.
Radio works at least. There's something up there. I don't know how to get it yet. Maybe I could go on the roof. I fixed this for some reason. I got an achievement at least. Oh. What is that? A headlight. Alright, I think we're good here. Just don't want to miss anything. What is that? Handlebars? Unused steel trap, not to be touched. And that's orange juice. Alright, we need to go find some place to warm up. This is getting more interesting by the minute. White whiskey? No. Telephone.
Perhaps someone was expecting an important call. In any case, that person's in for a long wait. Carl already noticed that telephone services weren't provided in this area. The milk was sorted by color, from the whitest to the greenest, or in other words, from the freshest to the sourest.
Hamilton, I won't be your dog anymore. Snowmobile, ski.
Nice catio. They say it's supposed to soothe the soul. But with this powerful gale that seemingly never sleeps, it was far more likely to get on anyone's nerves.
Here we go.
Carl had a hunch that there had got to be a plan somewhere that could help him put this thing back together.
Oh, nice. So I can rebuild the snowmobile. That's probably for later. Fill up gas can. All right. I need to get the white whiskey and spices, and I'll give the caribou to that one dude. He'll give me winter clothes, and then I'll fix the snowmobile. And then I still have to find all four of the figures or the ghosts, apparitions, whatever. And then that should unlock the ice wall, so.
Carl deducted this was a map of the area. Were those pins pointing to places of interest?
Maybe. Shit. Oh man, I don't have any wood on me. I should be alright for now. For heat. Some more Polaroids. Barely used them. My camera. Follow up on a complaint.
Roswell. Atamipec. Same story. Large deserts conducive to extravagant follies.
Following up on your complaint, I'm afraid that the police cannot support your claim alleging the sudden appearance of a man who came from outer space. Alright. This guy was really into UFOs and aliens and stuff like that.
The man has a passion for intergalactic things. Back then, people were obviously scared of the Russian atomic bomb, but an invasion by extraterrestrials was a legit fear as well. Seems like the mechanic had made his choice. Weird stuff. Kind of a crossing between a colander and a hairdryer. What was it for? To play telepath? To protect against nuclear waves?
For mind readers. Manufacturer's Manual 1. Alright, I think this is the manual or schematic for the snowmobile. Get the spark plug I ordered back in August and still haven't received. That's probably what he hid in that bucket on the roof. Find the snowmobile. Oh, maybe that's the keys. Or maybe, I don't know. I think it's on my bunch of keys. Which should be on the generator powering my top secret workshop down south, in which I'm working on my equal top secret machine. Anyways, gotta find that key. Now that I've siphoned off the snowmobile's gas to feed my truck, I'll have to refuel it. Alright, so I gotta find a few parts, get the spark plug, then get the key, and then, yeah, gas. It's a lot. Alright, I think we're done here. I think I might go and check the general store just to see if there's ingredients there that I can steal for the caribou whiskey. Because I really want that winter jacket. And I'll take a look for that secret.
It was so
workshop.
Cold. Oh, already shit. Carl did not feel his toes anymore.
Let's warm up here, just in case, because the car doesn't isn't good enough to warm up. See that bottom left one by the lake? I think that's his top secret lair. We could go check out that later. But I want to go to the general store. Then up there. Maybe I should go. No. I want that that jacket. But there could be white whiskey there. Yeah, we'll just go to the general store and then check out those two other houses down here. The Berdard or... Yeah. French names. So let's go.